Okay, I want to make a little statement on the in custody death that I mentioned. On Sunday, January 9th, an inmate was found unresponsive in Metro Corrections on the medical floor. Personnel immediately started life-saving efforts. The inmate was transported to University Hospital, where unfortunately he passed. The inmate was a 66-year-old male who was booked into corrections on January the 5th. This is the fifth inmate that has died within 6 weeks. So this is very concerning. All cases are being investigated by LMPD's Public Integrity Unit. One case is being investigated by the FBI. We've initiated these upon the deaths when they occurred. I've asked LMPD to accelerate their investigations, and if we determine there's any type of pattern to these recent deaths, we certainly will open further investigations. It's been well communicated that corrections has been experiencing staffing shortages due to COVID-19. I want to accentuate that this most recent death happened in a medical housing unit where staffing is prioritized in the medical wing. This unit was adequately staffed with corrections officers and medical professionals at the time of the inmate's death. We've been in the process also of pushing for increased wages at corrections with a new side letter. Discussions were ongoing last week and over the weekend, and we expect the union to vote later this week. We're also in conversations with WellPath. WellPath is the jail's medical provider, and we're talking to them about a new contract that will devote additional resources to health and wellness services at the jail. So obviously we take this very seriously, and we offer our condolences to the families of all of the deceased. Any questions? You know, there's been five deaths, right? And they all have different circumstances behind them. The numbers show us that we average about a little over three deaths a year at the jail. I wish it was zero, but when you go back the last 15 years, it's about three. So the question is, you know, is something unusual happening right now, or is this just really tragic timing that's coming here? But the actions that we've taken at the jail have been numerous. We've been working with the state, which we hold inmates with the state, and oftentimes we're pushing the state to take those inmates on time, and frequently they don't. So we've had a very good cooperation with the state. So as of late last week, we reduced the inmate population from 1,665 to 1,412. So the state's over 45-day population is the lowest where it has been. That's important because we have about 50 folks that are out related to COVID. So the lower our population can be, the better it is in terms of spreading that over our personnel. We've also been trying to increase people coming to work at Metro Corrections. We've dedicated about $6,500 of retention incentives and premium pay to our sworn corrections officers, and an additional $500 for folks who will be vaccinated. And then we set aside $12 million to increase wages within Metro government, and part of that would be going to the Metro Corrections as well. And then, of course, we're negotiating this contract with them, which we hope they'll be voting on this week. And then inside the jail, we've been on the forefront of keeping inmates safe with vaccines. So I hope people see how seriously we take this, and a lot of actions are going on. So as we get more information here, we certainly will act accordingly. I asked LMPD today to let me know when they would have some conclusions that we could act upon. So ask them to obviously accelerate the professional integrity unit. So I'll have some more information on that later today. Yes. Yeah, we'll see if there's any kind of patterns at all. Well, that's a federal definition, as you know, from the Department of Justice. And I mean, if there's anything to suggest that, you know, we're going to involve the feds. We've already done that with one investigation where we asked the FBI to get involved in one of the suicides. I think you're just kind of weaving a couple things together and drawing your own conclusion there. What we're going to do is follow the facts, and let's see what the facts show us, and then we'll take the next step from there. What I hope to get from them is some timeline on when the cases will be concluded. Okay, well, thank you all for coming out, and stay warm.